Hi beautiful viewers, you're welcome to my channel. My name is Peace and right now I'm cleaning up this area so that I can start cooking our lunch. So while I was still sweeping, my neighbor blessed me with these goodies. These are hard-shelled passion fruits. Yeah, she just brought them for me. I'll start preparing this. These are oyster nuts. Some call them Zanzibar oil vines, but in our local language, they are called kulekula. So oyster nuts are climbing plants. They like climbing on high trees, like right now where I'm sitting. They are up there. When they are ready, you can't pick them from the tree. They just fall down. That's when you pick them and dry them and you start enjoying them. So right now we have some that we are drying and some that are already dry. So I picked from ones. I've picked from the ones that are already dry, and it's where I'm going to make my sauce for today. But before doing that, I think we should prepare the food, then I'll come back to this. Let me set up the fire and put our lunch, then we come to the sauce. We use polythenes for making our fire because papers take a lot of time, but polythenes work so quickly. So right here is our posho that I'm going to mingle. So before mingling, you scoop some water and put it aside. So in case you need to add more, you just get from wherever you've put and add. So this posho is not the extra white one, it's 1.5. You know they have numbers. One is the white one, this is 1.5. But it's still good. Yeah, posho in our country is a food that is eaten everywhere. In schools almost every day. In prisons. In most working places. Posho is the main food here. Posho and beans, actually. It's the food that is eaten in most of the places daily. Other foods are there as substitutes. So it's now ready. I'll go ahead and put it in the banana fibers. So they used to tell us that if you put and it comes out like that, that means it's ready. So this one is ready too. like that. So that's how. Now we are ready to go. So I'll let it boil for a while as I'm preparing the sauce. So now that I'm done with putting the food, I'll let it steam for a while as I'm preparing the sauce that I had told you before. So right now, let's start. So this thing has two layers on it. Yeah, so you peel off the first layer. Layer, and then it remains with this other layer here that we shall remove later. So when you cook it, it looks like scrambled eggs. It gives you a texture of scrambled eggs, but the taste is different. The taste is different, but it looks almost the same as it. The smoke is coming this side. I wonder why smoke looks for where people are sitting. It doesn't go in any other direction. So this is the layer that you remove, and it remains with this other layer that we shall remove later. By the way, this nut has a lot of oil. It has a lot of oil that you don't even need to add anything in it. You only add spices, but not oil, because the oil that it produces is just too much. Some people scoop it off, but I don't. I just eat it like that. I don't know why. I've never seen an oil company using this thing, because I've seen Simsim oil, avocado oil, peanut oil, but I've not seen oil from this thing. Yet oyster nuts produce a lot of oil. And it's something that you rarely find, because few people eat it, or few people know it. It's not something that everyone knows about. It's rare even in the markets. Smoke. So now I'm done with that session. This is the rubbish I got from that one. So after that, you're supposed to get something that's a little heavy that you'll use for breaking the shell to get the nut out, just like you're seeing me doing right there. So right now, these are the finished nuts, and this is the mortar that I'm going to use for pounding. But if you have a high power blender, it can work well. But for us here, this is what we shall use. It's a mortar. You use it for pounding until the nuts are ready. So let's start. So you be careful when you're putting, so that you don't put some of the pieces of the top cover might have fallen in. So you be careful and remove them as you're putting. That's why you don't just pour. Yeah, so that's our water. By the time we finish pounding, it will be ready. So you can see how it's crushing so easily within just a few seconds. But you make sure you pound it properly and all the chunks are finished, because if you leave them, when you're eating, those chunks will not get ready if you don't pound them well. So it will be irritating. So that's how it looks like when it's ready. And right now our water is also boiling. So I think we should now put it. So when the water is boiling, I always add curry powder. I add curry powder before adding the nuts. So right now I've finished putting the curry powder and the water is boiling, as you're seeing. So I'll go ahead and add the nuts. So that's how it looks like. So after adding our sauce, that's how it will look like. We've put sauce and curry powder, so that color is for the curry powder. So you have to be careful because it can overflow, so you have to stir. And you don't have to stir for a long time, because when it starts boiling like that, you just add salt and leave it. It won't overflow when you add salt. So when you put salt, it separates from the water. As you can see now, the nuts are separate and the water is separate. So after adding the salt, the chunks become as big as this. That's why I told you it looks like scrambled eggs. So right now I'll go ahead and chop my spices and then add and let it boil. I don't know if this can show oil, but oil is starting to form on top already. It's hard to see, but it's right here in the corner. That's oil. So after boiling for a while, all that you see on top right now is oil. So I'll go ahead and drop in all the spices that I chopped. But you don't need to fry them. So now after adding them, I'll let it boil for a while until they become tender. There, the sauce will be ready. So right here I have the two main ingredients that will make a difference in this sauce, and that's the Royco and the garlic. So I've put ginger just because I have it, but it's mostly Royco and garlic. Those two things make a difference in this sauce. So right now I'll add my ginger and garlic paste, but you could also use powdered ginger and powdered garlic as well. So that's how it looks like after mixing. If you just put it in a powder form, it makes chunks. It doesn't dissolve in the hot water or hot soup. It doesn't dissolve in anything hot. So you have to mix it in cold water before pouring it into anything. So right now, our vegetables are tender. You can see all that oil. It really produces a lot of oil. So now that the tomatoes are tender and all the other vegetables, I can now add my Royco. It's the last thing I always add, and we are good to go. So I'll let it simmer for about 5 minutes and then we serve. So if you want, you can add some coriander or parsley just to add some more green color. And if you have bell peppers, you can also add, just for color. So, right now our sauce is ready and it's serving time. Got that oil.
Look at that.